Right then, today I've got this gunnera leaf, which I've, or concrete gunnera leaf, which I made the other day, and there's a video on how I made this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint this particular leaf with a mixture of purple or violet and a green colour. Try and sort of emulate, I think a good example would be when you see cabbage leaves, some of those dark green cabbage leaves with hints of purple in them. Anyway, I've undercoated this leaf with an off-white, which is a white mixed with a bit of orange, and it's kind of sort of a little bit more orangey in other places to give a little bit of variation over the leaf. So the white is going to be left exposed in the ridges and grooves of the leaf. Right, so first of all I'm going to put a bit of violet on my brush, just a straight violet from the tube, acrylic paint of course, and I'm just going to lightly brush that in the middle. Maybe build up some layers. So I hope that's coming out on the video. Mixed in some brown or some burnt umber with some sap green, and I'm going to dry brush around the edges of the leaf with this colour and maybe just overlap onto the violet. Okay, so I ran around with the green and I've merged it in with a bit of the purple quite near the centre, just to merge the colours in. I'm going to go around the edge of the leaf now with a darkened up green, which is darkened with black. I'm just going to do that subtly, as I do like with most of the leaves. Okay, I am going to darken up the green even more with the black, and I think I might go around with a small brush and just do a subtle outline, very subtle on the edges. For a finishing touch, I wasn't going to do this, it looks okay as it is, but I've just lightened up the violet slightly, and I'm going to take that out from the centre of the leaf. Just bring it out a little bit. Right, so there we are, there's the leaf complete. I think that looks okay. And this one didn't take too long. I think the more detail you've got on a leaf, the easier it is to dry brush, and this has been a lot easier to do than the rhubarb leaves, where there's not so much definition, ridges and such in the leaf. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this, and thank you very much, and see you later.